Hello everyone, welcome to Craftaria. My name is Sarika and my channel is all about creativity. In today's video, I will tell you how to make cones for dot painting. In today's video, I will cover all the questions that I got from you all. I will share its pros and cons and I will make a sample design for you to watch and learn. If you want to learn how to make this beautiful mandala, check the link in my description box and you can go and watch this video. I post 2 to 3 videos every week. So if you have not subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and subscribe and press the bell button. So with that, let's begin today's video. So first, let's talk about material for making a cone. You can take any thin but firm plastic. I mostly use these plastic book covers. They are perfect for making cones. You can use aluminium foil cover, Ziploc bags or any other packaging plastic also. So here I have prepared all these plastics for making cones. For sticking the cones, I use the cello tape. For making the cone, you need around 6 to 7 inches long and 4 to 5 inches wide plastic, rectangle plastic. For making the cone, put your thumb in the middle of the plastic and from the other side start folding. Once you are satisfied with the shape of the cone, then you have to start putting the tape. First, put the tape on the pointy side of the cone and put a tape around it. Secure it from all the sides. Now this cone is all done. Now I'm going to make one more cone so that you can learn properly. You can see it and learn properly how I'm making, rotating it and giving it a right shape. Tape all around it so that the paint doesn't come out from any side. Now it's time to fill the cones with colors. So some acrylic tubes are just perfect and in the right consistency for filling up the tube. So we can just fill the cones with these paints and they are ready to use. So after filling the paint, just tap it down nicely and try to squeeze all the paint down. Now fold nicely 2-3 times from the top. Secure it nicely and then put the tape. You have to put the tape 2-3 times so that while pressing the cone, paint should not come out from the top. In some kind of acrylic tubes, paint is too thick and you have to mix it little bit with water or pouring medium to make it liquidy to fill in the cones. For mixing this kind of paint, just squeeze little bit of paint in a small spoon or palette. I always use some pouring medium to mix in the paints. It gives the right consistency and gloss to the paint. You can mix any other color with white paint and make a pastel shade. Now mix this paint thoroughly. You can add little bit water also. I use this spray water bottle. It is very convenient for mixing the paint. Your color should get soft peaks when you lift it. That's how you know that your color is in the right consistency and ready to be filled in the tubes. Next category is thin and runny paints. In India, we get these Fevicryl and flash paints. They are too thin for filling in the cones. So for that you have to make it little bit thick for putting it in the cone. So just put this thin paint in a spoon or palette and add some baby powder to it. You can use any talcum powder what you have at home. You can use it and mix it. This baby powder is very useful for mixing it in the acrylic paints. Now this color is also ready to be filled in the cones. Now let's test these cones. So this cone is giving nice dots. It's ready to be used. This other cone, you have to cut it little bit from the top so that paint should come out and you can use it. This is also working fine. And this one also, you have to cut it little bit and it will also be ready to use. Now I'll tell you how to use these cones for making different kind of dots. So number one is very small dots. Mostly we use these kind of small dots to paint around the very big dots. In the middle of the mandala, when we make a big dot, we usually go around and make very small dots. For this these kind of dots, this cone is perfect. You just have to touch the surface very lightly to make these kind of dots. Next comes is little bit medium sized dots. So you have to just press the cones slightly and put it on the surface, and these dots will be perfect. So for the same cone you can make all sizes of dots. So very small, little bit medium size, and number three is little bit more bigger. So you just press the cone little bit more with little bit more pressure and these dots will be done. If you think they are not coming in the perfect size, then you can just take a dotting tool and put it on every dot, and all the dots will be same size and perfect. So next comes swooshes. These swooshes or petals are very popular these days. All the dot mandala artists are making in their artwork. So for making these petals, it's very easy. Cones are very perfect to make these kind of petals. Just squeeze a little bigger dot and drag it with a thin tool and you will get a very nice perfect swooshes. And then you can make a bigger dot in the middle to give it a very nice, to make it a very nice flower. Next comes outlines or any other design that you want to make in your artwork. You can make any kind of design with this. It is just like your pen filled with acrylic colors. It will give a very nice, beautiful 3D effect to your designs. Next comes this jewel style 3D dots or leaves. For that, you have to make an outline with cone in a circle or leaf shape. Let it dry for 30 to 40 minutes and then come back and fill it generously with some other color. They take little extra time to dry out, but they give a very gorgeous and beautiful effect to your project. Now I will make a sample design and I will answer all your questions that I get about the cones. The first question that I always get is, doesn't these cones dry? Yes, they do dry from the opening, but that act like a cap for the cones. You just have to squeeze the point of the cone little bit and that squeeze out that dried paint, and these paints are ready to use again. So I don't find any problem with that. The paint stays good in the cones. The next question that I get is, how long does the paint stay good in the cones? I can tell you from my experience that I have kept these cones like this for at least 6 months. If you keep it in a box, nothing happens to the cones. Paint stays good in it. So for still, I'll advise that you make small quantity, mix the paint in small quantities and make smaller cones. For frequently used colors like gold, silver, white, you can make little bit bigger cones. But for the other colors that you are not going to use very frequently, just you make very small cones. Sometimes by overuse, cones opening get spoiled, like the shape doesn't stay nice and the dots don't come out very properly. So for that, you just have to discard that cone. You just make a new cone and squeeze out all the paint in the new cone and tape it and then start using the new cone. So that's my advice for it. Next question is, can I close the these cones with a pin? So I tried using the pins to close its mouth, but I didn't find it very helpful. The mouth of the cone becomes very big and then you cannot use it for making very small dots. So I mean personally I don't advise it. If you want, you can put a pin to the mouth of the cone. Some people use a tape to close the mouth. So if you are not using the cone for a long time, then you can put the tape on the mouth of the cone and then it will stay nice. Now I'll come to the section of pros and cons. So first one, I'll tell you that they are very easy to use. Even a small kid can use it, no doubt about it. They are very convenient to use. You don't have to fill the brush or dip the tool in the paint again and again. So it is very convenient. Your project gets completed very fast because you are not using the time to fill the brush or tool in the paint again and again. Even the beginners can paint with it flawlessly with little practice. Your paints don't dry in them and don't get wasted, so it is very economical. Now comes the cons. So in the beginning, until you get used to of painting with these cones, you feel little intimidated by these cones because as they feel very complicated. Next is, sometimes a cone doesn't work no matter what you do. Paint just gets stuck in this and it doesn't come out. So for that, I will advise you to just take all the paint out, check it for any lumps and fill it in the another cone and start using it. There is no use trying to revive that same cone. Just make another cone and start using it. So that's it, guys. I hope all your questions are answered and you found this video useful. Let me know in the comment section if you want to know anything more. Please subscribe to my channel and press the bell button. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.